Hello Peaches and welcome to today's video. So if you can't tell by the title, we are going to be looking at 21 home trends for 2021, and I'm going to be sharing my opinion, what I think of them, if I'm excited to see them come this year, or if I think we should just keep it moving. So let's get started. All right, so I put all of the trends into a few different categories. First, we're gonna go through our colors. Then I'm gonna show you our space trends, what's gonna be popular in like different areas of your home. Then I'm gonna talk about wall trends and also move into design, like decor trends on how we're actually gonna decorate those spaces. So let's get started with the colors. So the first color palette we're going to start off with is jewel tones. Now I am here for this trend. I love the richness that jewel tones bring to any space. As you can see, a theme throughout all of these pictures is just like a rich, luxurious look and feel to each room. So we're going to be pulling a lot of inspiration from jewel tones in this color palette. So we're going to be seeing a lot of sapphire blues, gold accents throughout all of these colors, a peacock blue, a fire opal orange, a rich amethyst purple, and of course my favorite, an emerald green. Anything that's going to remind you of jewels and gems, rich and luxurious, and I love the feeling that you just get in these spaces. Now, these colors really give you a sophisticated look, but I do think that they're a little bit more challenging to work with than some of the other colors, so I think that if this is the color palette you're going to go for in 2021, you really got to commit, because these colors are a little bit less forgiving than some of the other color palettes we're gonna see, and I think you have to be a little more intentional with them. Our second color palette is neutrals. Now in 2020, neutrals became more popular. They're always kind of a classic. You always use your whites and your blacks and your grays, but making their own color palette has been really popular. The simplicity since minimalist has been more popular, and I love it. I think that it can get a little bit boring, so you have to be very creative and strategic on keeping your rooms and spaces interesting. But as far as the color palette goes, I love it, especially like all of the nudes. The nudes are so beautiful, and I can't wait to see more of this throughout the year. Speaking of tans, that brings us to our third color palette. We have grays. So you can see on this color palette here, grays are really a mix of like a cool brown mixed with a warm gray. It's really those middle colors you see that merge gray and brown together. It's definitely not brown. It's definitely not like a bluish gray. It's definitely gonna be more of this like warmer gray, cooler brown. So what does that look like? It's a mix of just different types of grays and browns together. Like usually in the past we've seen like cool rooms or warm rooms, and in the past it's been very separated, I feel like, whereas now we're seeing a mix. So it's a very neutral color palette. If you look at each one of these individual photos, each of them are beautifully decorated, but it just doesn't look like a home and inviting to me. It just looks a little more like an IKEA stage room. So I think that this color palette will be a little bit difficult to work with in terms of making it personal, but I think it definitely can be done, and I'm interested to see how people use it throughout the year, but not my favorite of all the color palettes. Moving on to the fourth color palette are these peacemaker colors. Now, maybe you don't know what peacemaker colors are. They are the colors that bridge the gap between calm neutral colors and full-on brights. They'll usually play off colors that you see in nature, and so as you can see, we have like a mustard here, we have a sage green, we have like an almost ocean sky blue, a lilac lavender. So you can see in these collages how these colors work together. Now they're not quite in the pastel family, they're not in the vibrant neon family, but they're definitely colors, and I love this palette. I just think that if you have this color palette in your space, you're walking in your room and you are feeling fun. Now this color palette does lean to be a little bit more feminine, and it also gives me a little bit more of a youthful feeling, but you can definitely work with it. There's a lot to play with here. Now, one tip with peacemaker colors is it is a little bit more trendy rather than the neutral palette before. You want to be a little bit more careful when buying your big pieces that cost a lot of money, because this is definitely a trend and I can't see it lasting forever. So if you do really like this color palette and you want to bring it into your home this year, I would recommend getting more neutral big furniture pieces, and you can pair that with a fun lilac table that if you end up changing your mind or style later on, you can always just throw a fresh coat of paint on there and it's good as new, and it works with a lot of different styles. Or you can just have a very neutral, clean color palette in your furniture pieces and go in with your decor and accent pieces in these Peacemaker colors if you would rather it a little bit more toned down. You have that feeling of color all around you, but if the trend dies or you change your mind later on, you're not out hundreds of dollars because you still have your neutral core furniture big pieces. Now for our last color palette we're gonna see in 2021 is neutral earthy tones. Now we saw this in 2020, but it's just going an extra step this year. We're gonna be packed with rusts, warm greens, deep reds, slubby browns, any colors pulled from nature, just in a very rich form. And then we're also gonna have a lot of warm tones, including golds and beige, a mossy green I've been seeing a little bit at the end of 2020, and I'm very excited to see that keep going. We're gonna have some soft olives, an earthy orange, you know, a lot of this orange and green. I mean, if you guys saw my bedroom makeover in my own home, I have the green and orange palette going on. And you guys saw me do that kitchen makeover in my last video. Now that we did the equestrian green. So we're definitely seeing a lot of this orange and green already coming in from 2020. And now we're adding in this gold and just the richness of these colors. I love this mossy green. I think I'm going to start leaning my own home to mossy green. This color palette is definitely one that hits home with me. I am here for this. I love it. I just think it looks so rich, but it also brings a lot of nature inside. So I think that this will actually be one of the easier color palettes to style because everything works so nicely together that I don't really know if there's a wrong way of doing it. You can kind of use these colors in a lot of different areas and design techniques. And especially because we're stuck at home and we're not leaving as much as we used to, bringing these earthy tones inside, I feel like for me in my own space, has really warmed it up and made me feel like a little bit of nature is inside with me. So I love this. This is probably my favorite just for my own space. And I am very excited to see how other people use it. All right, so that is all for colors. I'm leaving this here for you guys to screenshot if you guys want a recap of all the different color schemes we talked about. Let's move on to space trends. Now, I only have three of these for you, but I did want to mention how our space in our home is definitely shifting as we've transferred more to work from home instead of being out all day. So now a lot of people who maybe worked in an office building didn't have an office space at home. But as we saw in 2020, it's a vital, crucial part of your home. I think this year we're going to see a lot more people cultivate their home office and make it a statement focal point in their space. So that's going to be crisp, clear lines. As you can see in all of these almost, there's a lot of shelving for decor, but also for storage, which I think is really important now that we're bringing work home. I think that making a space for inspiration to get you creative, to separate your home life and your personal life from your work life is going to be very important. I think a home office is a great place, especially in this era, to spend some time to really make beautiful because you are spending so many hours in these spaces and you want to be the most productive, best version of yourself to get the most effective, efficient work done that you can. Now, the second space we're going to see a lot more in 2021 is like a cozy corner. Now, obviously, as I said, we're going to be staying inside a little bit more, at least for a little while longer. And if you haven't already, then I'm sure going into this new year, you may want to incorporate a cozy corner into your home. So adding soft and comfortable elements into your space with a mixture of textures, adding maybe some fairy lights or taking down your Christmas lights off the tree and putting them in the corner to add some romantic twinkly lights, using textures like linen and wool. Maybe you have some extra time and you want to arm knit a blanket to throw in there. Just comfy, luxurious, cozy pillows, lots of blankets, basically like an adult pillow fort, having your own little sanctuary, almost like with your office space. You need a space to get the best work done. You also need a space in your home that's just meant for pure relaxation, no expectations, not thinking about work, not thinking about cooking or the kids or anything else, but just having your own space to unwind and decompress and deal with whatever is going on in the world or in your life. I think that these cozy corners are just a must have in 2021. Now for the third space trend we're going to see in 2021 is outdoor living. And honestly, any excuse to get out of the house, even if it's only a few steps away, it's definitely still great to feel the sun shining and to get your hands a little dirty. So having your own garden or having a seating place to have some friends over is really great. Maybe have some bonfires over the summer, anything to get outside and breathe some fresh air. But until then, even just setting up two chairs and a little table, it doesn't have to be crazy. Just, you know, making a cute little spread on a Friday night to eat outside. And I definitely think that that's a great way to just change your environment. And if you don't want to eat dinner outside, you could definitely set up some just chairs to go read a book. Make a little cozy corner outside so that you can still get that fresh air. I'm really excited to see how people use their outdoor spaces a little bit better in the summer of 2021. So those were the three major space shifts that we're going to see this year. Now let's talk about how we're going to spruce up our walls. I'm so excited to see people add some texture to their walls. So this year we're definitely going to see a heavy presence of nature inspired materials. So we've seen stone before in a lot of different types of architecture and design in the past, but we don't see it so much in modern builds. But I am here for this. I love the look of these big stones. Now there's a lot of different ways you can do it, but I think that the cobblestone just adds like this rich, luxurious feeling. And I also think it adds a lot of interest. So like you can see on this photo here on the right, it's all white. And if you were to cover this up, it's still a beautiful modern farmhousey type of feel. But adding the stone wall just adds so much interest and character and charm. And I love it. Now, just like the texture and the feeling that you get looking at any of these rooms, it's just like you're in Italy, and it has a very handmade feeling to it instead of just a generic drywall. So I'm very excited to see stone added to some spaces. Speaking of stone, we're going to see a lot of retro terrazzo, which is this speckled look here, as well as marble. Now, marble's been popular for a little while now, but I think it's going to be taken to a different level. Here is a marble wall, but I love this gold accent instead of just the plain gray and white. So I think that marble is going to add a great texture to walls. Usually we see on, obviously on countertops or in bathrooms, but I really like the look of it in like a bedroom as an accent wall or in a office space. You know, I think there's a lot you can do with it. Now, obviously you're not putting a massive rock on the wall. I think that's a little too heavy and not a very easy thing to add to your home just casually. But I think that nowadays there's so many DIY things that you can add to the walls with stickers and wallpaper, and they give the same look. And I'm very excited to see how people start to get creative with it. Now, this retro terrazzo is really cool as well. I haven't seen as much of it in 2020, but it's starting to show more of a presence. Now, there's different ways you can see this is all basically gray with a little bit of color, where this is much more colorful. Now, you can achieve this with wallpaper as well, but I really like the look. And whether you decide to put it on the walls or just make some vases with this texture, I think it's a very fun texture to add to any space, and it really changes things up. Every version of it is going to be different. Just like marble, every marble is going to be a different veining, and it's all unique. So I really like that aspect of it as well. And as I said, we're going to see a lot of nature pulled in. So we're going to see a lot of cork. Now, at the end of 2020, I heard more and more people talk about cork, but now we're really going to use it in big ways. Now, cork is very sustainable and it's beautiful. Now, in this picture here, you can see it is all just a full cork wall, which beyond it looking beautiful, you can take a thumbnail and put it in there and hang photos on it, like you could see here. People are using it in office spaces to have calendars, to put pictures up, to kind of, you can post whatever you want up there, or you can just keep it really simple like in this photo and just have some really cool texture to the wall. You can do it very affordably and simply, and it's lightweight and it's an easy material, and I love the results. And I think that that's probably one of the easier ones to do. Now, shifting to another easy solution, but with a very different feel is fur. And there's a lot of ways you can do it. So here, this purple is very vibrant. It gives me a very 70s vibe. And I think that's really fun to just do over a door to add a little pop. Or you could do a whole wall with a more neutral color, like in this photo. And it really adds texture. Now this, I don't know if it's a real fur, it's more of like a skin, it's probably faux, but I really like how this zebra looks and I just wanted to include it to show you lots of different options. But I think it's a really fun way to spruce up your space and you can do it in a small little area and if you hate it later on, you can just take it down. So it's very versatile, it's renter friendly and I think it's really cool and unique and changes up your space really well. So then we have wallpapers. Now, wallpaper has been here since the beginning of time. Everybody loves wallpaper. But I think in 2021, we're going to see some really heavily patterned wallpaper with brighter colors. Now, there's endless possibilities and now they've made it so simple for you to apply wallpaper yourself. So it's very affordable. Also, you can do this on just a door or your whole room. So it's kind of however much you want. It's not that big of a commitment. And a lot of them are renter friendly, so you can just take them down whenever you move out. But I think that this, for an accent wall, if you don't want to do your whole room, is such a fun way to add texture. Now, obviously, there is wallpaper that's a little bit more simple, but I think that this coming year, people are really going to want to change their space up and do something a little more vibrant. And I love all these different patterns. Look at what it does. It almost has the same effect as paint, but it gives you different dimensions. And like, I'm not gonna sit there and paint all of that. So I really like this option as well. Wainscoting, okay? Wainscoting, again, is a little bit more traditional. It doesn't work for every space, but if you wanna add a little bit of dimension to your wall without going crazy, here's a great option. Now you can do this, they have kits that you can do this to buy. Or if you are into DIYs, then you can just get some wood from Home Depot and make some cuts yourself. Now there's a lot of different patterns. You can do simple rectangles like right here or squares. Here's just different size squares, whereas here's more of like a more intricate pattern. So there's lots of different ways you can do it. As simple or as detailed you want, you can go for. Now you can leave it just white like the rest of the room. It just adds an extra level of detail to your space that I am here for. Now, I do love a good accent wall where it's painted over top and it's just a focal point for your room, for your eye to look to, and I am here for it. And it's very simple for you to do. So I love this trend and I probably will be implementing this in my own home. Now, none other is wood beams. Now, I told you guys we're gonna see a lot of nature come inside. Well, the exposed beams have been here and they are making a even bigger impact in 2021. I love the exposed beams. I like the raw wood and it gives me very like we're in a cabin feel, like very handmade type of feel, and I love it. Now, there's a lot of different ways that you can do wood though. So this is the more traditional here where you're seeing almost like the beams that are keeping your home up. And I like that look. That's probably what I lean more towards. But now, obviously, we always see wood flooring, but we're going to see even more of that this year. Wood floors are always popular, but I think now we're going to show more of it on the ceilings and even on the walls. Here's a very modern look of just beams right next to each other on the ceiling to give a different textural look to draw your eye upwards. And here is the same type of thing. They have it both on the ceiling and on the walls. Just a fun way to add texture. And you could definitely do this yourself as well if you're into DIYs. And it's a really interesting, unique look. I know for my own home, I would love to eventually have some exposed wooden beams. Now, obviously, to show the actual structural beams holding up your house is more of a decision that you decide to leave exposed in the build. But nowadays, it's so simple to put up a faux beam that's not actually bearing any weight, but just gives you the same type of look. And I think that's a really fun DIY that's pretty simple to do. Overall, we're just gonna be seeing a lot of raw, untreated wood in 2021. And finally, we're going to see a lot of decorated tiles and high-end ceramics. Now, we've always had tiles in bathrooms, but I think that this year it's going to make a migration out of the bathrooms and be used more as a decorative element. There's so many options. There's so many faux tiles you can get on Amazon that create such an awesome look in your space that's very easy to apply yourself. But I think that this year we're going to see a lot of artistic tiling happening, not only in the bathrooms, but in other spaces as well, in your kitchen, maybe as like an accent focal point in your entryway. There's lots of places that you can actually use tile, and I think people this year are going to get a little more creative with it. I'm very interested to see what people come up with, because I never in a million years would have thought to do this botanical multi-directional tiling, but now that I've seen this picture, I could definitely see myself using this in my own home. I think we're going to get real creative this year and step out of our comfort zones, like we've seen even with a fur wall. I think that's really changing things up, and I'm excited to see where it goes.
Comment below your favorite wall trend, and now let's talk about what decor we're going to use to decorate our spaces.
So moving on to the last category, we have decor trends. So by that I mean, what are we going to decorate our houses with? In 2020, we did see a lot of minimalistic art, and I think that's going to carry over through to this year. And by that I mean simple line drawings without so much detail or shading, simple shapes like circles and lines. But it's not going anywhere, and it's going to be staying throughout 2021 as well. If you guys saw my video, I'll link it here, where I made my own art. I do really love this style of artwork because you can so simply create it yourself. It's kind of not meant to be perfect. It's very simple and accessible to everyone, so I really love that. I really like the simplicity of it, and it's also a great way that you can change your art really easily throughout the year. So if you get tired of something, you just draw something else new. Now in 2020, we saw plants really popular, and they are here to stay, if not adding more. Now we're trying to get a full jungle inside because we can't leave our house, and we want the nature and the energy, and that freshens our air and filters out pollutants and releases oxygen and just overall boosts your mood. So I think that this year people are going to add even more plant babies to their collection. But not only are we going to be seeing alive, thriving plants like these ones, this year we're going to see a lot more of the dried florals. Now, as the human connection to the outside world grows, we're going to see even more of pampas grass, which we saw a ton of in 2020. And it's inspired us to explore other grasses and dried foliage. So not only are we going to be seeing pampas grass in 2021, but we're going to be seeing all different types of dried flowers, dried plants, and we're going to start making bouquets out of it, using it as decor throughout our entire space. And by having these dried foliage in our home, it's really going to bring vibrancy and color to our spaces. And I think it's nice because it's not like a plant you have to water every day, and it has longevity, and you can really do this with any flower. Now you don't want it to look like just a dead mess, so it's definitely important to be strategic with what flowers you're picking, but I really love this trend, and I'm excited to see how people start styling it in their home.
In addition to craving the outside indoors, we're also craving comfort and a sense of calm. So now more than ever, our comfort and functionality of our furniture is way more important and prioritized than just a beautiful piece of furniture. So the design coming into 2021 will be much more about actually living with our furniture and in our homes and being comfortable in our spaces over just beauty. And because we're looking for this sense of peace and calm, I think that this shift to round furniture will definitely be seen a lot this year. We're very used to seeing the L-style sectional, and while these angular pieces of furniture add a lot of direction and a feeling of security to a room, this new wave of curved furniture adds a lot more softness and creates an effortless flow. And this round furniture trend definitely makes pieces feel like they're statement pieces and focal pieces. And I think that this year, spending so much time at home, we're looking to shift up our spaces and do something a little different. So this is the perfect way to change up your space, but also add a bit of softness to your space. Plus, a great thing about this type of furniture, it can really fit into any style. The only downside of this type of furniture is that it's a little bit harder to decorate with, in terms of it doesn't sit flush to a wall like a normal angular couch. So you definitely need a lot more planning, and you have to be more intentional with it. And these furniture pieces do tend to take up a little bit more space. So to compensate for that, it may be better to scale down a little bit and get a smaller couch, and also to make sure this type of furniture goes smoothly into your design is to balance it out with more angular pieces, so you don't just have a bunch of round bubble type furniture, but you're mixing the round pieces with angulars as well to keep it really interesting.
On to our next one, we are going to be seeing a lot of statement headboards this year. Now, there's lots of ways you can do this. Something a little more traditional is just like simple wood headboard, but in 2020 we saw a lot of rattan, and these headboards with this just rattan handmade craft to them with so much detail is definitely going to be present. But I'm also totally here for this luxe velvet type of antique vintage headboards as well. Now these totally play into that jewel tone color palette. You could do it in any color, but I think that the richness is very present in the jewel tone palette as well as in this style of headboard. So I think that we'll see a lot of those mixed together. Anything to make your focal point your bed. Now this year we're going to have a lot of organic presence, as I said, you know, with the plants and with the organic color palettes. We're going to be seeing a lot of organic materials used in spaces along with vegetable based fibers. So last year we saw a lot of this in wicker and rattan, the popularity of that really increased. And we're going to pull inspiration from handmade pieces from places like Bali, for example, but we're also going to up that, dive deeper into our organic materials. And now also with the rise of sustainability, I think that people are starting to really look at different materials to use for home builds all the way down to home decor. What materials are being used to make all of their decor? And we're going to see a lot more innovation in what our decor is made of. So we're going to be using a lot of things from the earth, things like rattan and wicker, which we saw last year, but even more so, we're going to start using silks, hemp curtains, and as I showed you in the walls, using cork walls, because that's also sustainable. We're also going to be shifting more into luxe decor. As we're spending more time at home, we care more about what our design looks like. And I think that this year we're going to see a lot of rich textural expression, as well as more just luxe decor and home design overall. We're going to pull a lot more inspiration from these type of designs. If maybe not an entire space designed about around luxury, we're definitely choosing pieces that are based out of luxury more so than just like the IKEA pressed particle board. I think the trend is shifting more towards being sustainably friendly, and so that also means maybe spending a bigger investment in our pieces that we're going to carry over long term instead of buying new every few years. Also, quality is becoming more important again. Before, it was very trendy to be in fast fashion of home design. I think we're going to see a lot more real wood in our furniture pieces, and then we're going to see a lot more luxe fabrics, so velvets, silks, things like that. So I think we may splurge a little bit more but get better quality items.
On that same note, I also think that customization and personalized furniture and decor is going to continue to skyrocket over this year, because we're splurging and we're going to get exactly what we want. And as we're spending more time at home, we are able to decide exactly what's working for us and what's not. And we're going to order custom pieces to fit our personal needs.
I really like this idea of caring a little bit more about what's in our home and making our home a space that we absolutely love and want to be in and are excited to spend so much time in. And I'm actually really excited about pretty much all of these trends. I think it's going to be a lot of fun to see what people do this year and how people get creative and how these trends play out in people's homes. I'm so excited to see all of the creativity in interior design in 2021. Comment below the trends that you liked and also the trends that you didn't like as much. And if you guys like this video, don't forget to give it a big thumbs up. If you want to see more videos like this, then don't forget to hit subscribe and turn on that bell notification to get notified every time I post. As always, thanks so much for watching. We'll see you next week. Bye.